The teams for this classification match at the Riverbank Arena line up as follows, beginning with the Islamic Republic of Iran. In goal, number 12, Maysam Shojai. Number 2, Amir Porazavi Haftaran. 9, and captain, Hussein Rajapur. 10, Behzad Zad Ali Askar. And 11, Ahmad Reza Shah Hussein. Substitutes number 1, Morteza Mabudi Dalivand. Number 3, Masood Golazde Abdul-Jabbar. Number 4, Mohamed Keshkar. Number 7, Abdulhamid Shah Havista. And number 8, Mohamed Haydari. And now the Turkey side. In goal, number 12, Ismail Koç. Number 2, Mikhail Güçlü. 5, and captain, Ali Çavdar. 6, Ramazan Kunduz. And 9, Karaman Kırbetoğlu. Substitutes number 1, Ali Hidir Kurt. 7, Mücahit Hüseyin Uslu. 8, Vedat Yavuz. 10, İbrahim Uzum. And 11, Abdullah Sumer. Our referees are Nils Haupt and David Bryant. Our officials, Francois Cassouet and Paul Levesuch. Scorer, Perry Gascoigne. And our timekeeper, John Wan.
Good game, enjoy it.
It's the first classification match in the Riverbank Arena in the race for fifth place at London 2012. It's the Islamic Republic of Iran versus Turkey. A reminder, please, that while the ball is in play, our athletes require absolute silence from the stands. Thank you in advance for your cooperation.
It's Iran, Turkey.
No problem.
You want the word or the flag?
No problem.
So ladies and gentlemen, kickoff is 30 seconds away. 30 seconds until we need silence at the Riverbank Arena. So one more time before kickoff, let's hear it for our athletes from the Islamic Republic of Iran and Turkey.
And a very good morning to the Riverbank Arena here at London 2012. We have superb late summer, stroke early autumn weather here in Great Britain at the moment, certainly in the English capital, London, because the Riverbank Arena is, as you can see, bathed in sunshine for this men's football five-a-side match. This is the 5-8 classification playoff. Remember these teams, Iran and Turkey. Iran, who finished third in Group A, Turkey bottom of Group 4. So there's no medals being handed out, but the winners will go into the match to to try to finish either fifth or sixth. The losers into the match to finish seventh or eighth. Spain, Argentina, Brazil and France, the four sides that qualified through the groups. And this is Turkey with their number six, Ramazan Kunduz, who squares the ball. And one of the interesting things, if you haven't seen the five-a-side football competition before, it differs a great deal, as you can see, from the seven-a-side, because the athletes don't want, during the game, while the ball's actually in play, they don't want the support of the crowd. And that is because the crowd must remain still, because there is a noise inside the ball. There are ball bearings that rotate inside the ball. They make a noise, so the blindfolded athletes here will know where the football is. The only sighted players here are the goalkeepers. They are sighted. They can't leave their area, though. They have to stay inside that D. It's the Turks on the attack again. A good interception from Shah Hussaini Adakani, the number 11. Shooting opportunity. Well, just for a moment, I thought there was for Kubatoglu. And the goalkeeper will safely take that. So the four outfield players, as I say, they rely on, well, on listening to each other, for one thing. And to the ball, as I say, which has that noise-making device. And they also have guides on the side of the pitch and on the pitch. The goalkeeper being the guide in the defensive third of the pitch. Here's Turkey coming forward. Look like a little push there. Now the coach is the guide in the midfield third, and there is also a sighted guide alongside the attackers in the attacking third. And that's Iran's Shah, allowing the ball to roll out, but it is in fact a corner. Pitch, as you can see, has a rebound wall. No throw-ins, there's no offsides, but there are corners. The blindfolded players are allowed inside the D, but the goalkeepers aren't allowed outside. So now it's Iran coming forward. Shah Hussaini Adakani, shown early on that he means business, looks a skillful player. So Spain and Argentina won Iran's group. Iran did have a victory over the host nation Great Britain by a goal to nil. They lost 2-0 to Spain and Argentina to finish third in their group. It was a good shot from Turks Kunduz. And in Group B, Turkey, I'm afraid, lost all three of their games heavily to Brazil and China by 4-0 and 1-0 against the French. So bustling his way forward. Oh, off the post. That was very, very close for the Turkish number two, Mikhail Guklu. Good pass, crossfield from Kurbatoglu. Yengehe was dispossessed there, and now it's the captain, Ali Kavdar, coming forward for the Turkish side. Well, that's an excellent ball, and here's an opportunity. Good save, though. Well, it's Kurbatoglu with the shot. Very early stages, just 4 minutes played, but already the signs, I think, are that Turkey may be marginally the stronger side here. And that despite the fact that Iran did get a win in their group. The officials, by the way, it's a German referee, Niels Haupt. And the second referee is from Great Britain, David Bryant. The third referee, Francois Carcu from France. That move breaks down. Karaman Kurbatoglu can't keep the ball in play. Sure, a shot there of Mikhail Kaya, who's the Turkish coach. And you can just see the official guiding the Turkish player to the ball by rattling it around. Mesam Shojayan, the Iranian goalkeeper, has already made a couple of good saves as Turkey prepare to take this corner. Mikhail Guklu, the number two there. No, he's just dribbled the ball straight out there. Needs to go backwards rather than forwards across the dead ball line. And these players have to wear eye shades with the exception of the goalkeeper. Some of the players are completely blind anyway, but some aren't. Some are partially sighted. So to make it fair, level playing field, everyone has to wear the blindfolds. It's a good mazy dribble. Abakani still on the ball, but eventually the Turkish have it back. That ball is going to run dead. The group matches, of course, could be played to draws. And in fact, in the Group A, which was Iran's group, there were some drawn matches. But here, we need a result here because we need to know which classification match the winners and the losers go into. So we do need a winner and a loser as a shot comes in there well off beam. And that will be the Iranians to restart. If it's a draw, we'll have a penalty shootout. 25 minutes each half with a 10-minute break at half-time. Yenge here of Iran, twisting and turning, trying to shake off no fewer than two, make that three now, Turkish defenders. Eventually, again, runs the ball out of play. Well, Shah Hosseini Adekani does like a dribble, and he's kept going a long way, and he might get a shot in, and he has, and it's just wide of that left-hand post. The Turkish goalkeeper, Ismail Koç, was really stretching there. Immediately ball transferred down to the other end of the field, but Kurbatoglu can't reach it. So 8 minutes played, still 0-0. Iranian number nine there, Rajabpour, the captain, went without the ball, so chance for the Turks through their captain Kavdar to dribble across the halfway line. There's a little trip there, but the referee says it wasn't enough to draw the foul. There's one main referee, as you can see on the pitch, assisted by the two assistants. You've got to be careful not to give away too many fouls, because if a player individually commits five personal fouls, they are sent off. Guklu has lost that to Pora Javi, who's the Iranian number two. Needs to make a tackle. That was a good tackle from Ramazan Kunduz of Turkey. But still, it's the Iranians who have the ball. Tackle again from Kavdar. Launches the ball downfield. There are two Turkish players waiting, but there are two Iranians to just mop up the danger. And here's the Iranian number nine, Rajabpour. Again, just dribbles the ball out of play. And a steep learning curve for both these countries. But both of them, but particularly Iran, actually, have a lot of young players who you would expect will still be around playing the game in 4 years' time. Look down their team with a 24-year-old in goal, 23 at the moment, 24 later this year, as Iran attempt to come forward again. 27 and 26-year-olds, and then a couple of players who are even younger than that. So Iran building for the future. Shot comes in from distance. Not going to trouble the goalkeeper that. Good tackle. Rajabpour, the captain, still in possession. We're into the 11th minute here. Riverbank Arena, beautiful sunny day as Rajabpour, the captain of Iran, tries the shot, which is blocked, but they can try again with Yengeje. His way through to goal is blocked now by Kunduz. You can just hear in the quieter moments when the voices from the coaches die down, you can hear, I think, clearly the ball bearings, the noise-making device inside the ball. And two Turkish players in danger of tackling each other there. That's a good run by Shah Hosseini, but... Oh, and he's still going. Now this is an opportunity. Goalkeeper dives early. And then dribbles the ball out of play. Should really have got the shot away there, I think. We're seeing a change early on.
Turkey leading the field, number 5, Ali Chavdar, replaced by 7, Mujahid Hussein Uslu.
So the midfielder, Uslu, Mujahid Hussein Uslu, replacing the captain Ali Kavdar, plays in Ankara. The new man, Uslu. It's an attacking move that, because nominally the... Oh, here's an opportunity. Good save. Well, that could easily have been the first goal of the match. It's a corner, not a foul, a corner to Yengeje. And Ali Kavdar is listed as a defender, Uslu as a midfielder, so it's an attacking change, you could call it. Not sure, the last touch actually wasn't off the Iranian player. But anyway, they have the decision. Yengeje and Rajabpour pull the ball away from the goal. There's Kurbatoglu trying to burst through the middle. Oh, it's an excellent dribble. Here's an opportunity. Good save again. And that should be a goal kick because the keeper forced the rebound actually onto the Iranian number 10, Yengeje.
Substitution for the Islamic Republic of Iran, leaving the field number 9, Hussein Rajabpour. Replaced by 3, Masoud Golazde Abdeljabbar.
So a bit of switching around here from the Iranians. They're bringing on a defender and taking off an attacker, their captain Rajabpour. They're bringing on Golazadeh.
Each team is permitted to take a 1 minute tap out per half, and Turkey have elected to use theirs.
Well, I'm sure you heard that clearly enough. timeout called by Turkey, one per half per team. You don't have to call them. Turkey have elected to do that with 13 minutes and 20 seconds played. Need to take on a little bit of liquid. It's still early morning, really, in London. The temperature is warming up, and great news, really, for the Paralympic organisers, particularly the organisers for the outdoor sports, is that we are in for something of a late summer burst of sunshine here. Had a look at the weather forecast today, and we are in for some beautiful weather today, Thursday here, Friday, Saturday, and all the way through to Sunday. Weather should be glorious and actually very warm for Britain at this time of year. Talking about up to 84 degrees Fahrenheit on Sunday. Should ensure everybody's walking around with a smile on their face at least. Nil-nil then, about to resume. 11 minutes and 40 seconds to go in this first period. And the Turkish number nine, Kurbatoglu, puts the shot away, but then immediately Turkey, Iran respond. Shah Hosseini battling with Guklu. Clears long downfield, but can't find a teammate. And Iran, to their credit, who I thought started very slowly, and Turkey had the best chances. And now here's Iran again with Yengece. I think the Iranians could argue that they are now the more dangerous of the two teams. Definitely Turkey started brightly. One really good chance and a really good save from Ismail Koç. So Iran's corner, can they get to the shot? Well, not immediately. Yengece is still in possession. Oh, the ball just rolls away off his right foot. He's setting himself nicely there to have a right-footed shot. Substitute Golizade. Shah Hosseini loses out there to the Turkish number seven, Uslu. Great dribbling skills from Uslu. And that's a free kick. Well, that's probably the best bit of dribbling that we have seen from Mucahit Hussein Uslu. He plays in Ankara. The Iranians resorting to the foul.
Thank you.
So it's a four-man Iranian wall, which in a five-a-side match means everybody bar the goalkeeper. Not a lot of room there. So Turkish free kick, opportunity then, Uslu, the number seven, is there. Goalkeeper set his wall, and he is to the left of it as he looks. That's the attacking coach, just marking out the posts. It's all done using the player's hearing. Shot! Oh, that's a good save. It was Uslu who shot. Worked it well in tandem with Karaman Kerbatoglu, the number nine. It was Uslu. Oh, no, it wasn't. It was Kerbatoglu who had the shot, and it was a really good save from Shojejan. So Güçlü off, and the captain, Ali Çavda, comes back on. That was probably the best save of the match, I think, from the keeper a moment or two ago. Yengeşe through the middle. Oh, he's going all the way. And then the ball just rolls away from him. Good run. Two Turkish players. Well, that's a foul, surely. Two Turkish players, unfortunately for them, collided, and now they are out of the play as Iran break. Shah Hosseini. Think we'll need a bounce up here.
Substitution for Islamic Republic of Iran, leaving the field number 11, Ahmadreza Shah Hussein, replaced by 9, Hussein Rajapour.
So Captain Rajapour back on, in place of the number 11, Shah Husseini, who's been a threat. And Ibrahim Uzum, first sighting of him today. Well, that's Güçlü. The number two, it's Kunduz who has come off for the Turkish side. Oh, great goal! Wonderful goal from the Iranians, from their captain, Hussein Rajapour. Well, straight after the restart.
Goal scorer for Islamic Republic of Iran, number 9, Hussein Rajapour.
Well, there was very little Ismail Koch could do about that. Right into his top left-hand corner. He got a hand to it, but he couldn't keep the shot from Hossein Rajapour out of the goal, and the Iranians have the lead. And after a bright Turkish start, as I said a little earlier, I think, well, it's been pretty even, but overall, probably Iran have shaded it. That said, their goalkeeper has made a couple of really good saves. Çelkaya, the Turkish coach, has one or two things to think about now. I was actually half watching your official clock when that goal went in, because for some reason it didn't restart. We lost about 10, 15 seconds. It didn't actually restart the clock. That's a foul. Foul by Uzum. Clearly took Yengezhe's legs. So Iranian free kick, but the shot in the end is a long way from goal. Well, the goalkeeper can't come and collect that. He's not allowed out of that little square, so a rectangle, I should say, not square. Good run here. Well defended, though, by the number 2, Porajavi.
Substitution for Turkey, leaving the field number 9, Karaman Kerbetoglu, replaced by 7, Mucidik Hussein Usman.
Uslu on for Kubatoglu then. It was Kubatoglu's free kick that was probably the best chance so far for the Turks, but it's the Iranians who lead, and into the side netting from Yengezhe.
Okay.
Iran lead then by a goal to nil, and here they come again. That's a very, very long dribble from the goal scorer and captain of the Iranians, Hossein Rajabpour, but the shot in the end was off target as Turkey tried to attack. Ball just rolls out of play. It will be a restart for the Iranians, who I have to say really have started to take control of this game. And hit. Oh, there was an opportunity there. Slack pass, and Yengeje just didn't hear the ball in time. But he didn't touch it either, so it's a corner. Oh, he did touch it. That should really have been a restart to Turkey. Good tackle from Uslu. Good tackle as well from Yengeje. Yengeje continues his run. And the left-hand side, can he keep the ball in play? I think that's a corner. It is. Well, the Iranian number 10 is causing problems. The goal scorer, Rajabpour, walks over, but it's Bejad, Zadlia, Zhgari, Yengeje, who is causing a lot of the problems here for the Turkish defence, who are very much on the back foot in this game now. They are relying more or less on breakaways. It's the Iranians who are having a lot of possession, a lot of territorial advantage here. Rajabpour, captain of Iran, still going. Excellent dribbling from Rajabpour. The key is getting to the shot. Lovely footwork again. Eventually, he's dispossessed. But almost immediately, these two, the 9 and 10, Yengeje and Rajabpour, are causing all sorts of problems, really, for the Turks. But now they have won the ball back. You'll notice we have the countdown period now. Last couple of minutes of each half, the clock is stopped whenever we have a free kick, a kick in, a corner, a substitution, as we're having now. So Uzumov and Kurbatoglu comes back on, the man who had the best opportunity in this first half with that free kick that was definitely going in.
Substitution for Islamic Republic of Iran, leaving the field number 9, Hossein Rajabpour. Replaced by 11, Marquesa Shah Hussein.
Well, big hand for Rajabpour. Iranian captain has had a splendid first half, capped by scoring a very well-taken goal, which gave the goalkeeper Ismail Koç no chance whatsoever. So Abdullah Sumer on, and here, well, momentarily was a chance for Kurbatoglu. Still got the ball. Well, it was worth the effort. He'd probably been told there were a matter of seconds remaining. So at half-time here at the Riverbank Arena, the lead is held by Iran in this 5-8 classification game. Iran at the moment looking good bets for going into that fifth and sixth playoff. Iran leading by a goal to nil, scored in the 19th minute by Hossein Rajabpour, the captain of the Iranians. Splendid strike.